Hello and welcome. First of all, thanks for your interest in our products and our company. My name is Wolfgang Jaksch. I'm the founder and CEO of MediConsult International. Today, I would like to briefly introduce you to one of our newest inventions and developments in the field of energy medicine, intelligent wellness. What's behind that nice term? Most of you are probably familiar with the term wellness. It's 20 years ago, 25 years ago, wellness was defined, you know, with probably going into a sauna for a couple minutes or lying in a nice hot tub, you know, with some bubbles. But within the last 20 years, you know, this term became much more powerful. Because nowadays, if we talk about wellness, we have powerful technologies which support this term. And if you define it nowadays, we could also say wellness means the balance between the body, the mind, and the spirit. And if we put these three terms together, we can also combine it to the word health. Because if your body, your mind, and your spirit works together in a perfect synergy, then you are a healthy person. The term intelligent, I would like to introduce you a little bit later, because with our newest technology, IMRS, Intelligent Magnetic Resonance Stimulation, we are able not only to apply some kind of information to your organism, which helps you to stay healthy, or to get back your health, we are also able to observe your reactions during this application and, in case it's necessary, to adjust these kind of signals which we apply to you. But first of all, some very interesting facts and predictions what's going on in our world according to health and disease. The prognosis for 2050 says that about 22% of the entire population on planet Earth will be over the age of 60. So that means people become older and older, and of course, you know, they also have the right to live a healthy lifestyle even in the older ages. And you know, if you work for 40-45 years, I mean, you deserve after retirement, you deserve a healthy and an active lifestyle, even if you become older. So it makes absolutely sense already now, probably if you still work and if you're not retired yet, to think about ideas and concepts which you can become proactive and which you can promote your health or protect your health so that you can live a very healthy retirement life. Even today, very interesting, let's look on diseases. 60% of the entire population of planet Earth die from the consequences of chronic diseases. What is a chronic disease? According to medical definition, a chronic disease is any disease which is at least 6 months or longer. So that means, you know, three of these chronic diseases are the cause of 60% of population's death nowadays. And these three chronic diseases are cardiovascular diseases, strokes, and cancer. So you can see that even if we probably know about hundreds of different diseases, these three chronic diseases, they make 60%, or they're responsible for 60% of the death of the entire population on this planet. And according to the healthcare systems, the prognoses are not very bright, because in about 10 years, the worldwide healthcare systems can no longer be financed and will collapse. So this is another reason why people have to start to become proactive, to protect their health, and to look for applications, for concepts, how they can be proactive in securing their own health. So that's very, very interesting, and this is actually the fact why we are here together and looking for the possibilities and the opportunities we have to do so. Let's take a look at our environment, you know, because we have a lot of changes in our environment within the last 100, 150 years. There was one major invention in history which changed the entire environment on our planet tremendously, and that was the invention of electricity. Because with electricity, it was actually the first time when we had to deal with artificial informations, with artificial vibrations, because electricity is something which is which doesn't appear in nature. So, you know, based on this invention, electricity, we have a completely different world nowadays. You know, we have elevators, we have escalators, we have cars, we have computers, we have satellite systems, we have and so on and on and on. You know, we have mobile phones. All that stuff, you know, would not exist without the invention of electricity. And we are surrounded more and more by so-called artificial high frequencies, which do not have a natural cause. And that creates a lot of problems, which people even don't think about, because the worst part of these kind of frequencies is that we cannot detect them, because we do not have an organ to detect these kind of waves, these kind of informations. Well, I would say we don't have an organ. We don't have an organ yet. Maybe, you know, according to evolution processes, maybe we will have organs in 1,000, 10,000 years, which we are able to detect these kind of harmful frequencies and stay away from them. But nowadays, we don't have them. So this is actually something you have to become aware of, that by changing the environment, you know, and it's going so fast, we are not able to adapt as fast as these changes appear. And that creates a lot of problem when we talk about disease. You know, we have modern diseases, for example, allergies. Allergies were not known 150 years ago and before that time, because there was nothing to be allergic against. Now, with the changes in our environment, you know, people become more and more allergic on different things, and that creates a lot of problems. Did you know that we have worldwide about 5.5 billion cell phones in use, and also about 1.5 billion personal computers already? You know, so that's a huge amount of sources for electromagnetic unnatural vibrations. You know, not talking about all the additional inventions which came out with these inventions, for example, wireless internet, and then I already talked about the GPS systems, the satellite TV, and all that stuff, you know. This creates an environment which is not natural anymore, and which creates a lot of problem, you know, how our organism reacts on that. The consequences of these environmental changes, you know, it leads to adaptation problems. We are not able to adapt to these changes as fast as we should. So we're always running behind, you know, our environment, and that creates a lot of problems within our organisms, which finally, if we are exposed to these kind of problems for a longer time, which finally leads to disease. Let's talk about the quality of food. You know, we have too many people on this planet already. So the resources, you know, to feed these people are not enough. So what do we have to do? We have to artificially create food. You know, especially in North America, you know, we deal a lot with genetically modified food, and nobody asks how our organisms will react on that. But believe me, it creates a lot of changes in your entire organism, which finally probably lead to a disease. And that's a huge problem. So if you want to stay healthy, also when you become older, take care that you get always the best quality of food. You know, the same with water. Water is an essential force in life. You know, without hydration, our organism cannot function. So that means, you know, if you want to take care of a good overall function of your entire organism, you know, hydrate well. But also, you know, hydrate with a high quality of water. People are not aware that tapped water contains of a lot of chemicals already, and if you drink tapped water every day, your body and your organism becomes toxic. So you change the entire environment inside your organism, and it will not function properly anymore, and it leads to disease. And that's a huge problem. And I already mentioned it, the potential increase of electrosmog. You know, we in Germany and Switzerland, we have a nice term for all these unnatural vibrations. We call it electrosmog. You know, smog, most of the people are aware of this term and they know what's behind that, you know. Electrosmog is the summary of all these unnatural vibrations which we are surrounded by and which we cannot run away from it anymore because they are all over. So, you know, if we want to create an environment where we still have the possibility to live with it without becoming ill, we have to look for solutions to deal with it because we cannot run away from it anymore. So, you know, as a conclusion, what choices do we have today to protect our health? Very simple. You know, the best way to protect your health, the best way not to become ill is to stay healthy. So prevention is the key. But you can only do prevention or be preventive if you have the knowledge what to do. And it also needs some kind of motivation. So you have to be motivated, you know, to keep yourself healthy. And that's a tough approach because, as you know, we mostly become motivated when we are already ill because we want to get rid of the disease and we want to become healthy again. So, the biggest motivation for human beings to become healthy again is to being ill before. But this is not the idea of holistic approach. You know, we want to keep our health and maintain it on the highest possible level so that we do not give a chance to ourselves to start suffering from a disease. And that's the idea. But like I said, you have to create some knowledge and you have to make some personal experiences to benefit from preventive modalities. And therefore, we are together again, you know, so that we can discuss that a little bit. And I hope I can give you a lot of good ideas what you can personally do to become proactive in staying healthy. Create a fundamentally natural environment. That's very important because we are used to live in a natural environment. So our body feels best when it's surrounded by a known natural environment. And nowadays it's becoming harder to do that, but with the right kind of knowledge and with a little bit of motivation and with a little bit proactivity, you are still able to, you know, to reserve some natural environment around you which helps your body to maintain health on the highest possible level. And finally, we must learn to understand our organism as a part of the universal system. You know, it's not like we are the people who dictate the entire system. We are only a small part of it. And, you know, we have to live according to these natural laws because we are only a little part of it. You know, we are only a summary, a collection of little atoms which are put together and which makes us look like me or look like you. So that's why, you know, a little bit look around, a little bit opening the horizon would help a lot to understand that we are just a small part of the entire universal system. So let's talk about electromagnetism. I already discussed or I already talked about the harmful electromagnetic fields. On the other hand, you know, I started my lecture by telling you that we are able to create some beneficial effects on your entire organism by using electromagnetic fields. So you know, this seems to be not go along very well. On one hand, I tell you electromagnetism is good. On the other hand, I tell you electromagnetism is bad. So what's behind? You know, using this analogy, it's probably the same as snake poison. You know, snake poison can kill, but snake poison can also cure. So the difference between killing with snake poison and cure with snake poison or heal with snake poison is the dose you apply. And this is exactly what applies for electromagnetic fields. You know, electromagnetic fields can be very harmful, but electromagnetic fields in the same time can also be very beneficial. It just depends on the dose and on the content of these kind of vibrations. Electromagnetism, for most of us, it's an unknown field because most of them relate electromagnetism to the terms electricity and magnetism. You know, in fact, it's a much bigger spectrum we talk about. Electromagnetism also includes visible light, for example, you know, or infrared, or radio frequencies. These are all frequencies out of the electromagnetic spectrum. You know, there is only one frequency range which we do not refer to electromagnetism, and that's the ultrasound waves, because ultrasound waves are mechanical gained waves which are not within the electromagnetic spectrum. So if we talk about electromagnetism, we not only talk about electricity and magnetism, we also talk about, for example, visible light, infrared, ultraviolet, all, you know, the complete range, almost the complete range of existing vibrations in our atmosphere we live. How electromagnetic waves can have an impact on life, we can see at that slide. I love that slide because it gives you a little bit of an idea what's going on. Our Earth contains emits an electromagnetic field. You heard probably about that, the Earth magnetic field. The Earth magnetic field is a very gentle, very low intensity electromagnetic field, and it is actually gained within the inner and outer core of our planet Earth, and it seems that it has a huge impact on life. Because if you, for example, compare it with our moon, you know, you can see the moon does not emit an electromagnetic field, and it looks quite sad. You know, there is no life on the moon, you know, comparing to our Earth, where we have the living colors, green and blue, when you look at it. So it seems that the Earth magnetic field creates a huge impact on life, and there is a relationship between these kind of energies and our existence and our functions. So why do we need magnetic resonance stimulation nowadays? Why do we need electromagnetic fields in our organism to benefit from it and to maintain or to increase our potential of health? With our fast changing world, you know, we can see that everywhere, you know, the construction density, because more and more buildings were built, you know, to host all the people on this planet, you know, these concrete buildings, they actually block the natural frequency of the frequencies of the Earth magnetic field already. So that means we are slowly sliding in a kind of deficiency on the natural vibrations which we need to maintain our healthy status, and as well as, and this was mentioned before, all the artificial frequencies we are surrounded by already, you know, electrosmog caused by all these nice little inventions in the modern times, you know, they disturb and interfere with these natural frequencies, so we do not get the information according to the content and also according to the strength the way we should, and that creates a lot of problems. So in general, what I'm going to tell you is, you know, I could even tell you that electrosmog, so all these unnatural vibrations, they do not cause primary problems for us, but they interfere in the natural vibrations, so we are actually slowly sliding in this kind of deficiency. We do not get the natural vibrations we need to maintain our organism on the top level. And of course, we exercise less and less. You know, human beings are the same as animals. We are designed to move. That's why we have these huge muscles on our legs, you know. The problem is we don't use them so much anymore. And that creates a lot of problem because, you know, movement is life. So the less we move, you know, the less or the more problems we create according to our body functions. So, you know, for all the people who do not move as much as necessary anymore, go out and do your daily walk, because it has a primary impact on your health right away. And if you don't do it, and you know, if we always stay in these kind of overloads, we we slip in a situation that most of our important metabolic processes in our body are being reduced and compromised, and that creates most of the health issues we have to face nowadays. So how do we utilize the electromagnetic fields caused by our system, the IMRS, intelligent magnetic resonance stimulation? To understand this, we have to take a look inside our body, because our entire body is made of single cells. You know, cells are the smallest building blocks within our organism. A lot of cells together create tissue, a lot of tissue together create an organ, a lot of organs together create an organ system. So if we really want to catch the cause of health and disease, you know, it would absolutely make sense to start at the cellular level, because this is the smallest building block. So looking at the cell, you can see that on the slide on the right side, you know, it looks like a bubble, you know, and each cell has a electric potential. You know, most of the people know that we have a lot of chemical processes going on in our cell, but believe it or not, we have a lot of energetic processes also going on. And my favorite phrase is, without energy, no chemistry. And so the energetic approach is even more fundamental than the chemical approach, because without energy, there is no chemistry. And this is where magnetic resonance stimulation takes action. What actually happens is, you know, so that your each of your 70 trillion cells, that's the average amount of an average person, 70 trillion cells, so that each of your 70 trillion cells works properly on the highest possible level, it needs a certain membrane potential. It needs to be at its best shape to make sure that all the solid and liquid food you put into yourself, let's say it like that, you know, that it will be utilized as best as possible. And that's why, you know, it is important that each cell creates a certain membrane potential to change all this liquid and solid food together with the oxygen into energy, which is physically known as ATP. The term is in English is adenosine triphosphate. That's actually the stuff which we know as energy. So that the cell is able to produce this kind of ATP, it needs to absorb the highest possible amount of all the nutrients, all the minerals, all the oxygen we apply. And therefore, it needs a lot of energy. And there is where magnetic fields come into place. What we actually do is we have a lot of ions, you know, they are floating around, you know, even in the cell, inside the cell, it's also outside the cell. So if we want to create a potential, an electric potential, a membrane potential, we need to motivate these ions to move. And to do so, we apply a pulsating electromagnetic field. And what we do, MediConsult, with our IMRS systems, we found out that the most powerful and in the same time the most gentle way to do that is to apply a magnetic field which is very close to the intensity and content of the Earth magnetic field. So that's what we actually do. We create an electromagnetic field which pulsates so that we can kick the ions to move, which leads to a high membrane potential. But the cell only kicks in if it understands the signal. And as we evolve with our environment, with all the natural vibrations, it makes absolutely sense to exactly apply these kind of vibrations. And that's what we do by applying magnetic resonance stimulation. The result is very simple. You know, you increase the membrane potential of each of your 70 trillion cells. So the ability to absorb the nutrients, the minerals, the oxygen, you know, increases, and that leads to a higher production of ATP. And if your body is full of ATP, you are full of energy. You are full of energy to support your immune system. You are full of energy to support your brain functions. Every single function in your body is totally improved. And this is actually probably the most basic holistic application which you can do nowadays, magnetic resonance stimulation. A system, an IMRS system, comes with a whole body applicator. It also comes with a pillow and a probe applicator for all different kind of applications. Usually we say the whole body applicator, that's the daily cell wash machine. You know, so you use that every day. The best will be at least 2 times for 8 minutes. And if you have additional issues, something like, you know, regional pain or even pain spots, then you can either use the pillow or the probe applicator. The probe applicator also works very good for electroacupuncture, for example. So you have all the different options to apply beneficial, healthy, and natural electromagnetic fields onto your entire organism. The conclusion is, with the help of a precisely defined pulsating magnetic field, we can boost and balance the membrane potential of each of your 70 trillion body cells. Your entire metabolism will be improved, and therefore the energy production will be optimized. Here you can see a nice slide where we can even show you some kind of evidence. On the left slide, you're going to see red blood cells. And these blood cells are not so happy in this picture. So their membrane potential is already diminished, decreased, and that leads to a lower surface to absorb oxygen. You know, as you know, the red blood cells are responsible for carrying oxygen within the entire organism. As more oxygen you can carry through your entire system, the better your metabolism works. If the membrane potential of a red blood cell is already diminished, it cannot absorb as much oxygen as necessary and possible. And that's what you can see on this left picture, that these red blood cells, they already start sticking together. They lose even more surface to absorb oxygen. After an 8-minute application on an IMRS, you can see the difference on the right pictures. These red blood cells become happy again. Their membrane potential increases, which immediately leads to a better absorption of oxygen, so all your metabolic function will be increased just by delivering a better amount of oxygen. And you can see that in the right little video. So that was, in general, about magnetic resonance stimulation. Now let's also talk about the additional options you have, which you can add to your IMRS system. First of all, ISLRS. ISLRS stands for Integrated Sound and Light Relaxation System. We developed a system, and the idea was to develop something which works synchronized and in conjunction simultaneously with the IMRS. You know, I'm getting back to German, sorry for that. So, but I'm sure you understand what I'm talking about. Simultaneously with magnetic resonance stimulation. And this is a technology which is called brainwave entrainment. What is behind brainwave entrainment? Brainwave entrainment is based on the philosophy of a stimulation to activate the brainwaves to resonate with external stimuli. You probably already had the opportunity to see your own brainwaves, because it's possible in classic medicine to do that today by doing an EEG, you know, a electroencephalography. You have the possibility with this kind of diagnostic system to make your brain waves, you know, your brain functions visible. And believe it or not, you know, what you see on a EEG graph is nothing else than electric activity. Because if you have activity in your brain, your neurons start communicating to each other, and that creates an electric potential. And this is nowadays possible to make it visible. If we take a look at an EEG graph, you can see mostly 4 different kind of frequency patterns. We have the delta, the theta, the alpha, and the beta waves. Sometimes we also see gamma waves, but they are mostly not present and not detectable with a regular EEG. So let's concentrate on the four different brainwave patterns we have. For example, if you are very tired, you know, you probably, when you do an EEG, we're going to see more longer wavelengths within your EEG graph. And these are the delta or the theta waves, depending if you're just tired or if you already sleep almost without consciousness. So you can see, you know, depending on which kind of frequency patterns we can determine on your EEG that also relates to a certain mental status of yourself or of the person the EEG is taken. So what we can say is, if we can see which kind of brainwave patterns we can see at the moment we do the graph, we can automatically relate it to your mental status. And you know, further on, what we can do with it, we are able, if we, for example, if we apply frequency patterns which are almost not present, the brain starts to take this information and to try to go in resonance. So that means it starts building up these frequencies which are not available at that moment, and that leads to a change of your mental status. And this is a very cool idea, brainwave entrainment. So we can actually correct and help our brain to create certain frequency patterns which are not available at the moment. And we have to understand that principally the human brain produces all these kind of wavelengths simultaneously at any time. But however, normally a specific frequency always prevails. And this is actually the frequency which determines the mental state of the person. And you know, by applying ISLRS, brainwave stimulation, we are able to finally correct the frequency patterns, and we can so influence the mental state. That's the idea of brainwave entrainment. That's the idea of integrated sound and light relaxation system, ISLRS. It's actually wellness for the brain. What the IMRS with the whole body mat, with the pillow and the probe does for the body, the ISLRS does for the brain. And an ISLRS system comes with a LED goggles which emits light frequency patterns, and it comes with headphones. And you're gonna hear some weird tones. Some people even called one of our offices and said, "Hey, I think my ISLRS is not working right because I hear some weird tones." You know, no, these weird tones, they are on purpose, because these are very specific frequencies which lead your brain to go in resonance with, together with the light frequencies emitted by the goggles. And so we have an audio-visual application to balance your brain frequencies. That's the idea of ISLRS. And last but not least, I promised you, you know, to tell you a little bit more about the World Intelligent. Here we are. We developed a complete new system which is optional available for any of the three IMRS models. And this is the IMOR system. And the IMOR system stands for Interactive Monitoring and Regulation. Here is a little animation which shows you a application together with the IMRS when you lie on the whole body mat. You know, most of the systems available on the market work exactly the same way. They have a control unit which is able to create all these necessary frequencies. And we have this blue cord which goes to the applicator. So it sends the frequency pattern to the applicator, and the applicator, you know, in our case, it has six copper coils built in, and they are creating actually the electromagnetic exposure. So there are no magnets inside that applicator. It's very important to know, because we create an electromagnetic field by sending a little voltage through solid copper wires and coils, and that's how we actually gain an electromagnetic field, so no static magnets or something like that. So that's how it actually works. What's new now is the green connection. So we connect the user, which is lying on the mat, or and together with the control unit, to get some feedback from the person during an application. So we observe the reaction of the user during an application, and we determine some kind of status, and then the IMRS decides whether the applied electromagnetic field according to its intensity and frequency range is the right one, or if it has to change something. And this is intelligent. So that means, you know, it actually makes a MRS application more powerful because it talks to the user. How do we do that? We use a technology which is very, very well known since many, many years, even in classical medicine, and the term is called HRV, heart rate variability. What is heart rate variability? It has nothing to do with the heart rate. We actually need the heart rate to determine the heart rate variability, but it's two different pairs of shoes, so don't mix it together because it's two different terms. Heart rate variability is not heart rate. The definition of heart rate variability is nothing else than it's a chronological constant measure which gauges the intervals between individual heartbeats. So what we actually measure is the breaks between two heartbeats. And if we analyze 60 heartbeats, we are also able to analyze 59 breaks between the heartbeats. And these breaks, they have a certain time length. When we now start to compare the time length of the different breaks, you know, through a built-in algorithm, we get a result which tells you whether these breaks are very synchronized or whether they have different time lengths. And this is actually, you know, the difference between the breaks. That's the term HRV, heart rate variability. And we know that people who have a high flexibility in their heart rate, they are much better able to adapt to environmental changes. So the more flexible your body reacts on external stimuli, the better your health status is. And this is a very powerful measuring which we are now able to get out of your body during an IMRS session, because we can determine your actual HRV during an application. And depending on the result, the IMRS is able to correct the intensity of the applied magnetic field, and first of all to make it more dynamic for you, and also to get a better, to get your HRV in a better status, you know. So you probably had the intention that a very synchronized heartbeat is really good, because usually synchronization is good. But if we talk about our heartbeat, it's completely the opposite. The more flexible your heartbeat is able to adjust, the better your HRV. So a high HRV is a good sign for overall health. A heart rate that does not vary or adapt anymore is not good. And then we talk about a low HRV, a low heart rate variability. So the revolutionary benefit of an IMOR system as an option together with your IMRS is actually a dynamic regulation of the electromagnetic field and intensities during an IMRS application. And over time, and that's really the cool thing about it, over time, you know, if you always use a dynamic HRV measuring and the IMRS adjusts the intensity, over time you're going to train your HRV, and a better HRV automatically results in a better longevity. And this is actually what we understand, you know, as intelligent wellness, you know, a overall application for the entire body in conjunction with the ISLRS and IMOR. You know, we all also include the brain, and in addition we have the possibility to react on certain changes right away and correct it. And this is intelligent wellness. This is our brand new system, which is available now also in North America. And if you need further information, you can, of course, you know, check the content on our website, imrs.com. You can also check our corporate website at mediconsult.tv. Or even better, you know, you talk to one of our certified lifestyle consultants all over North America if you need further information, and they are more than happy to support you in any case. From my side, thanks for your attention. I hope you got a little bit of or good valuable information out of this little lecture, and of course I wish you the best health, and hopefully or probably we see each other one of my travels through North America. Thank you very much.